Let's talk about the end behavior of polynomials. And when I say end behavior, I mean the limit as x goes to positive or negative infinity of a polynomial. So to start out, on the top of the page here, I've written a rule. So we'll read the rule and then I'll do a few quick examples to show you how to use it. So the rule for the end behavior of polynomials is this. The limit as x goes to positive or negative infinity of a polynomial, represented here by p of x, equals positive infinity or negative infinity. And which of those it is depends on the degree and the sign of the leading term. Okay, so if we're taking the limit as x goes to plus or minus infinity of a polynomial, we know our answer is going to be one of two choices, positive or negative infinity, and which one it is depends on the degree and sign of the leading term. Okay, so let me show you a few examples. Now, what I mean by the leading term is the term of the highest degree. So in my first example here, f of x, 3x to the fourth is my leading term. Okay, so when I say that my answer only depends on the leading term, this is what I'm saying. The limit as x goes to infinity, so we'll do positive infinity first. The limit as x goes to infinity of f of x, of that whole polynomial, equals the limit as x goes to infinity of the leading term, 3x to the fourth. Because that term has the highest power, it dominates the behavior of the polynomial. Okay, so let's look at the limit as x goes to infinity of 3x to the fourth. So I said above that the answer would depend on two things, the degree of the term and the sign of it. So let's think about those things one at a time, and let's pull that coefficient out front. Okay, so what's the limit as x goes to infinity of x to the fourth? Well, we know from before that that's positive infinity. Okay, so we have 3, which is positive, times positive infinity, so that's going to give me positive infinity as my final answer. Okay, so now let's do the limit as x goes to negative infinity of the same polynomial. So once again, my answer only depends on the leading term. So I just need to think about the limit as x goes to infinity of 3x to the fourth. Once again, let's pull the coefficient out front so we only have one thing to think about at a time. All right, so I'm doing the limit as x goes to negative infinity of x to the fourth. So I have x raised to an even power. So raising a negative to an even power is going to give me a positive. So the limit as x goes to negative infinity of x to the fourth is positive infinity. So once again, I have a positive times a positive. So I'm going to get positive infinity as my overall answer. Okay, so we see that this polynomial goes to positive infinity on both ends. So let's look at a different example. So here I have a different polynomial, but we're going to use the same approach. So we'll look at the limit at positive and negative infinity. So first of all, the limit as x goes to positive infinity of g of x is the limit as x goes to positive infinity of the leading term. Now the leading term in this case is negative 4x cubed. Remember, the leading term is always the one with the highest power. It's usually listed first in the polynomial, but not necessarily, so be careful with that. Okay, so what do we have here? Once again, let's pull the constant out front. Okay, so I've got negative 4 times the limit as x goes to infinity of x cubed. So that's going to be negative 4 times. Okay, so what's the limit as x goes to infinity of x cubed? It's just positive infinity. I'm putting really big positive values into x cubed, so I'm going to get really big positive values out. But what do I have here? I have a negative times a positive, so that's going to give me a negative overall, so my final answer is actually going to be negative infinity. Okay, what about the limit as x goes to negative infinity of g of x. Well, that's going to be the limit as x goes to negative infinity of the leading term, negative 4x cubed. We pull the negative 4 out front. So we're doing negative infinity here. Okay, so I've got negative 4 times the limit as x goes to negative infinity of x cubed. Okay, so here I have an odd power. So if I plug negative numbers into an odd power, I get negative numbers out. So this limit is actually going to give me negative infinity. So here I've got a negative times a negative. So I've got negative infinity, but with a negative 4 out front. So that's going to give me positive infinity as my final answer.